Today I'm going to show you how to create these 5 shapes in Adobe Illustrator. What's going on everyone, my name is Tom from Dreadlabs and today we're going to go back to where it all started. If you're a long-term subscriber, you might remember this series where I tried to recreate 5 rave shapes. The reason we call them rave shapes is because they mostly turn up on rave flyers. Some of these of course originate from different cultures or from different time frames or whatever, but usually you can see these a lot on rave flyers. So before we head into the video, I wanted to let you know that if you are not good at Illustrator, if you cannot follow the tutorial, or if you're just lazy and you just want to use these shapes for yourself, you can actually download them yourself without following the tutorial by becoming a Patreon member of mine. Check around the link in the description or stick around until later in the video to learn more. So without any further ado, let's dive into it. Alright, so we're gonna go from left to right here, starting out with the yin-yang sign. Let's start out with the ellipse tool. And we're gonna set our foreground color to nothing by pressing slash on our keyboard. And for the stroke color, I'm gonna pick the same color as here, which I'm gonna do with the eyedropper tool. And I'm gonna press I on my keyboard to get the eyedropper tool. And I'm gonna hold shift on my keyboard and click on the color. By holding shift on my keyboard, I'm making sure that I actually change the color of what I have at the front here, instead of just copying the entire appearance. Because if I would click this without holding shift, you can see that it turns to like the actual appearance of this part of the shape. We don't want that. So back to the ellipse. Let's click on our canvas here and we'll make an ellipse of 750 by 750 pixels. And we're gonna align this to our artboard like that. So now basically we wanna grab our circle, press Command or Control C to copy it, and then press Command or Control F to paste it in place. So if you've been paying attention to the layer menu, you can see that there are now 2 ellipses and basically they are in the same place. As you can see, I'm gonna move all of this to a new layer so you can actually check out what I'm doing in the layers as well. Anyways, so what we wanna do with this second circle is basically scale it down, but we're holding shift so it will stay uniform, and we wanna make sure that we scale this up into the half of the circle height. Like that. That's 375 pixels. We now want to do a second one, and I'm just going to copy drag this. So I'm holding Alt or Option on my keyboard, and then clicking and dragging on that circle. And while not letting go of Alt, I'm also holding Shift to make sure that it will also only move straight down. And here we have it, the base. So now we want to select both of these smaller circles, go to Object, Path, Offset Path. I want to make these smaller. So minus 100 pixels will probably do. So you can already kind of see where it's going to happen here, but we're going to select this and go to the Shape Builder tool. And we're going to click and drag here, and we're going to click and drag here. And now we're basically just going to make sure that we select this one and this one. And we're also going to fill this in. And there we have it. All right, for the second one, the reason why I want to showcase this is because this looks kind of abstract, as you can see, but this has some pretty interesting methods that I don't see a lot of people talking about in about Illustrator. So I figured it might be useful to showcase these methods. So we're going to start out with a simple square of 750 by 750 pixels. And the first thing I want to showcase is basically the dash line. So we're going to grab the pen tool by clicking P on our keyboard. And we're going to just draw a line from one anchor to the other one, and this will give us a normal straight line. But if we click on the stroke, you can actually check on dashed line here, and we can even determine how large we want the dashed line to be. Let's just keep this at 15. So we're going to do same thing as we did with the circle. We're going to copy and paste this in place. So Control or Command C, Control or Command F. And then we're gonna grab the rotate tool by pressing R on our keyboard. And we're just gonna make sure that we rotate this the same way, but then 90 degrees. So if we hold shift, we're gonna make sure that it actually rotates 90 degrees, like that. So hold your mouse over where it says intersect with the ellipse tool selected, of course. And we're gonna click and drag while holding Alt and Shift. We're actually gonna draw the circle from the center on out. And I'm gonna go back to stroke and check off dashed line. So we're almost done here. The only thing that's left to do is actually make that waveform shape. And that's actually really, really easy. So I'm gonna just draw out a line here, and I'm gonna make sure that it's aligned to the center. And with the line selected, we're gonna go to Effect, Distort and Transform, Roughen. And as you can see, this basically already creates a waveform, but I'm gonna show the options for you real quick. So you have a relative and absolute form. The relative one is in percentages, so as you can see here. But in absolute, you can also do this in specific pixels if you want to. So for this, I think 15%, maybe lower, maybe 8. And you can also show how much detail you want. So the more you go to sort of right, the more of these wave sliders you'll get. But in our example, we have pretty much almost none. So I think something like this is okay. And if you want to, you can also smoothen the corners if you like that. I figured the sharp ones are a little bit better in my opinion. I like them better in this way, in this case. And of course, you can now go to Object, Expand Appearance. And if you do want to have like this part where you have these middle lines, you can also just select two points here with the direct selection tool. So press A on your keyboard to get the direct selection tool. Select these two points and select these two points. And we're going to align them to the artboard like that. And there we have it. You can now also even scale it up if you want to, or add other effects to them. For example, when you go to here and you add the bulge effect, you'll even make this waveform a little bit more drastic if you like. So it's not entirely the same as you can see, but that's completely fine. The cool part about this is that you can actually pretty much randomize a lot of this. All right, on to the next one. So for this kind of like sun looking shape, what I'm going to be doing is go to the center of our artboard, and we're going to draw out a line to the top. Let's do it like this. I'm actually going to showcase another distortion effect, this time the zigzag. And it's basically the same as the roughen, but it's not randomized. So it basically, it's always doing the same thing, as you can see here. Let's set the points to smooth. And we'll do less, we'll do maybe 2. And we're gonna go and make sure that this is now expanded by going to Object, Expand Appearance. I already have my shortcut there, so I did it already on my keyboard. And now we wanna grab the Width tool. You can find the Width tool here. You can also press Shift W on your keyboard. And on the top here, if you hold your mouse over the anchor and you click and drag, you can actually drag out the width of the stroke here. And we want to just drag this all the way inwards. And at the bottom one, we want to drag it outwards a little bit, like this. Maybe a little bit smaller on the bottom, like that. Now we're going to select our line, go to the Rotate tool by pressing R on our keyboard. Click on the anchor at the bottom. And as you can see, we now have our little icon there placed. And that means that if we rotate it, we'll now rotate around the center of the artboard. But then we'll hold Alt or Option on our keyboard. And this will bring up the rotate menu. And we want to have maybe like 24 or 12 different tendrils. So let's see what 12 will look like. And we can easily do that by going typing out 360 for 360 degrees slash 12. And then we'll click on copy. You can see that we have the second tendril here. And then if you just press Command D over and over again, we'll have the sun. As you can see, it's a little bit more empty, so I'm gonna just Control Z. So we're gonna do 360 divided by 24, and we'll copy. And then we'll press Command D until we have a full rotation, like this. And I'm gonna select all of this, and I'm gonna go to Object, Path. Outline stroke to the Pathfinder here. If you cannot find this window, you can go find it under Window Pathfinder, but it will unite everything. And of course, then we change the fill to a stroke. Make sure that it's the same size, like this. So if you are unfamiliar with how this works, so it might be the case that your art looks a little bit like this, where the points are a little bit too sharp, and that's because the mitering is basically like it tapers the lines. So if you put this all the way up, you can see that this actually makes it really, really like a lot longer. But sometimes if the lines or the corner is too sharp, this isn't possible, or it's getting crazy real large. And the way I try to solve this is always just align the stroke to the inside. And your stroke is never like exceeds from this furthest point of the shape here. All right. So there you have it. On to number 4. So when I just started out in Illustrator, I struggled a lot with geometry where it has was like either three-sided or six-sided. Something like this would be very difficult for me to make, but I've actually found a way to do this properly. So we're gonna grab the polygon tool and we're gonna just click and do a six-sided with a radius of 300. Well, it's a little bit too large maybe. We'll just make it 300 wide, if that makes sense. It's a little bit difficult in Illustrator to just copy and drag these and then align them perfectly because these are like sides. So I found a method to do that properly. Maybe you've already figured this out, but this was a revelation to me. So we're gonna grab the rotate tool, the one that we've used a couple of times so far in this video. And we're gonna just click on this anchor point right here. And we're gonna hold Alt or Option while we do that. And this will bring up the rotate menu that we also used in the previous shape. But this time we're gonna rotate this 120 degrees. And I'm not gonna click OK yet because then you can see what's happening here. Basically because with a hexagon like this, all of the three points will come together if these are linked. So I'm just gonna click copy and we're gonna do that one more time. And we get kind of like that beehive effect, if that makes sense. So we're gonna do that one more time here, rotate tool, and we'll click on this anchor point here, or this intersection, and we're gonna make sure that it's perfectly aligned. So it's either 240, 120, it's always in increments of 120 degrees. So we'll make another copy. And perhaps these are doable like this. See, this is what I mean. Like it's it doesn't really exactly like interlock here. So we'll do this manually with the rotate tool as well. And you're gonna keep going until you get like this honeycomb pattern that's like this. So we'll group this and we'll center it to our artboard and then we'll ungroup it. And you might already know how to advance next, but for the people that don't know, I'm gonna show you. I'm gonna select this one, and the middle one here. And I'm gonna go to Object, Path, Offset Path, and we're gonna do an offset of maybe 50 pixels. And an easy way to clean this up is just by immediately pressing Control or Command X before you do that. We'll delete all of these shapes in the middle. And then we're gonna just press Control or Command F to paste them in place back again. And there we have it. All right, so the final shape that we're gonna do here is basically this fake 3D look with a grid or a box or whatever. So this is actually pretty easy to do. So under the line segment tool, we also have the rectangular grid tool. Just gonna make a grid let's see, 6x6 squares. I'm gonna align that in the middle. We're gonna scale this a little bit down and maybe we'll do a stroke of 2.5 pixels because it's a little bit thick once it starts to scale down. So what you wanna do is hold Alt or Option and drag one extra grid exactly to the top. So if you go to Outline View, which you can get access to by pressing Control or Command Y on your keyboard, by the way, you'll see that it's perfectly aligned. That's what we want. We're gonna do the same thing, but then we're gonna align another one to the right here. I'm gonna select the top one, only the top one. I'm gonna press E on our keyboard to bring up the free transform tool. The free transform tool can also skew and like do perspective warps and everything like that. So we're gonna go to the top right corner here, click and drag. But while we are clicking and dragging, so don't let go of the mouse yet, I'm gonna press Control, Shift, and Alt. So all of these together. And you want to drag that out until this line starts forming and you have it perfectly aligned with the grid to the right. And then let go. And then we can just delete the right one here. Select the top one again. And it's easy if you do this with a grid with even numbers, because then you can just go to the middle cross here with the rotate tool, select it and press Alt on your keyboard and click. And I'm going to type in 90 degrees, copy and do that two more times by pressing Control D on our keyboard. And there we have it. Scale this down a little bit. And there we have it. Five more shapes to do in Illustrator to put on your Rave Flyers. So like I said in the beginning of the video, if you're new to Illustrator, maybe you're too lazy to follow the video, or maybe you just don't feel like it and you don't have enough time, and you do want to get the shapes that I made in this video, you can actually become a Patreon member of mine. All of my Patreon members get access to all of the project files from all of my tutorials. At this point, that's over 100 Photoshop files and I think over 60 Illustrator files already. And I also have Cinema 4D files, After Effects files and more. On top of getting access to all of these files, you'll also get a 15% discount in my asset web store where I'm selling textures, vector packs and more. And as a Patreon member, you can also get an exclusive Discord role in the Dreadlabs community server, which is a Discord server of our community with over 3000 members where we share designs with each other, ask feedback and teach each other new things. I also have a second tier on Patreon, which is a little bit more expensive, but this tier will also give you access to exclusive tutorial videos, as well as the project files from my Creatober challenge, which I just finished. By becoming a Patreon member, you actually help me create more videos for free for you guys. Because of my Patreon channel, I actually get enough income to make a free video for you guys every single week. If I wasn't getting the support from Patreon, I wouldn't have time to do this full time, which in return would mean a lot less tutorial videos. So a huge shout out to all of my Patreon members. Thank you so much for supporting the channel. If you want to become one yourself, check out the link down in the description. If you don't have the budget to support Dreadlabs, you can also just subscribe for 1 month and then unsubscribe at any time. You'll get access to all of the files in the first month. But if you really don't have the budget, but you still want to support Dreadlabs, of course you can do that by leaving a like, comment and subscribe on the channel if you haven't already. With all of that being said, this is Tom from Dreadlabs tuning out. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you guys in the next video.